7 international aid workers with the World Central Kitchen have been killed by Israeli airstrikes in Gaza. Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu has taken ownership of the deadly strike, but brushed it off as a mistake. But was it? I think it's important for Americans to judge for themselves, for the international community to judge for themselves, as we learn more and more details about the 3 separate airstrikes that happened back to back, which led to the killing of the 7 humanitarian aid workers coming from different countries around the world. Now, video from the scene showed some of the aid workers for the charity, which was founded by celebrity chef José Andrés, were wearing bulletproof vests. But let's talk about how it went down. And this is according to reporting from Haaretz. So the charity says a convoy of 3 vehicles had been traveling in a conflict-free zone in 2 armored cars marked with the charity's logo. In fact, if you look at some of the footage, you'll see that one of the airstrikes hit one of the vehicles in this convoy right on top, where you can clearly see the logo for the charity. They were on their way to a humanitarian aid warehouse in central Gaza. After unloading 100 tons of aid at that warehouse, the convoy proceeded to travel back on a pre-approved route that the IDF knew about. They knew about their existence. They knew their exact coordinates. This was something that they actually coordinated with the IDF in an effort to remain safe as they're trying to deliver this humanitarian aid. Now, they claim that they gave the IDF their exact location. Sources tell Haaretz it was then when the IDF was given the order to carry out the strike against the aid workers. So here's how the convoy was hit. And you read about the details and it's just absolutely devastating. So the first vehicle in this humanitarian aid convoy was hit by a missile from an Elbit Hermes 450 drone, which is manufactured by Israelis. According to Haaretz, people can be seen emerging from that vehicle, trying to escape and get into the second vehicle in the convoy. At that point, the IDF does another drone strike to hit that vehicle. At that point, the third vehicle in the convoy attempts to save the individuals who were hit with that drone strike, or try to get those passengers into the third convoy or third vehicle in the convoy. And at that point, Israel carries out the third drone strike. All 7 individuals in this convoy were killed. And if it seems unlikely that Israel would intentionally target and kill members of a humanitarian aid convoy, keep in mind that back in late November of last year, Politico actually reported this. I just want to give you a few excerpts here. The Biden administration has been providing Israel with the location of humanitarian groups in Gaza for weeks to prevent strikes against their facilities. But Israel has continued to hit such sites. The information included GPS coordinates of a number of medical facilities and information on movements of aid groups in Gaza to the Israeli government for at least a month, according to 3 people familiar with the communications. Still, Israel has launched operations against Hamas in or near aid sites, including hospitals, leading to the destruction of buildings and the blocking of fuel and other critical supplies. And so in this particular case, the argument that's being made by the Israeli side is, well, the IDF thought that there was an armed terrorist within that convoy.
Yeah.
Okay, so of course, there's no evidence of that at the moment. Let's go to Haaretz, where they report, according to sources acquainted with the details of the incident, the operation room in charge of securing the route identified an armed person on the truck and suspected this was a terrorist, just suspected. So let's do 3 drone strikes on the suspicion that there might be an armed terrorist within the convoy, which there's no proof of, by the way. By the time preparations were made for the attack, the truck arrived at the warehouse together with 3 World Central Kitchen vehicles carrying 7 volunteers. Minutes later, the 3 vehicles left the warehouse without the truck on which the armed person was allegedly sighted. At some point, while the convoy was traveling on the authorized route, the operations room ordered the drone operator to strike one of the vehicles. All 7 volunteers were killed. And I need to give Associated Press a little bit of credit for how they frame this, because this is absolutely correct. Throughout the war, they write, Israeli forces have shown readiness to inflict widespread destruction when they believe a suspected militant is present or when ground troops see a tactical need to strike. Homes with families sheltering inside are leveled by strikes almost daily. The military has struck ambulances and aid vehicles, saying that armed fighters were in them. So this tends to be the tactic that you hear from the IDF in regard to why they carry out these strikes, knowing full well that the strikes that they're carrying out are going to kill innocent civilians, and in this case, humanitarian aid workers.
Yeah, so if you still think that Israel is not killing civilians on purpose, you're either a giant schmuck, totally blinded by your bias, or you're an American politician bribed by AIPAC, illegally bribed, or you're a mainstream media reporter who's afraid to say things that are true. But now these days, most of the reporters are saying things that are true because it's super obvious. This is, and when you kill civilians on purpose, there's a name for that. It's called terrorism. And right now, Benjamin Netanyahu is easily the world's largest terrorist. So let me explain, because these are not just insults. These are backed up by facts. So let's take this one apart. So at this, in the beginning of this conflict with Hamas, I'm such a sucker and a dupe that I might have believed Israel if they had done this on October 8th or October 17th or 27th, etc. I probably would have believed them, even though they had already murdered so many journalists and so many innocent Palestinians, like of course Shireen Abu Akleh assassinated one of the most prominent Palestinian journalists and an American citizen, and they shot her in the neck with a sniper with no conflict anywhere around. So Israel's been purposely murdering journalists and aid workers and Palestinians now for decades. So, but nonetheless, I probably would have been enough of a dupe to believe that this might have been an accident. But at this point, guys, number one, here they admit they knew what it was. Did you hear what Anna said? They said, oh yeah, we thought there might have been a terrorist on board. But they're not saying we didn't know that it was aid workers. We didn't know that they were delivering food. We didn't know that it was humanitarian relief for Palestinians. No, they say we do know that, and we knew we were murdering them, but we thought it was justified because maybe there was a terrorist on board.
I mean, just complete disregard for human life.
Like, that's it. There's no argument about it. If you're making an argument that it was an accident, no, you be more precise with your language. It was not an accident. They very, very, very clearly said we did it on purpose. We meant to murder those people because we thought it was justified. Because if there's one Palestinian on board, they're a goddamn terrorist and will murder anyone near a Palestinian. So that's the Israeli government now. Okay, but more overwhelming evidence. Why is it my opinion even changed in the last 6 months? So where I can now say I'm absolutely certain they're doing it on purpose. Well, look at the evidence, guys. 196 humanitarian aid workers killed so far in this conflict. That is 3 times more aid workers than killed in any conflict in the same period of time. 3 times worse than the Russians, than Assad, than you name it, okay? So you're saying you have to admit that this is true. If you say that all of that was a mistake, then the IDF is the world's most incompetent military. They're just, they don't know where they're shooting at all. And oops, we killed 3 times more than the worst butcher in the whole world. We killed 3 times more aid workers. Okay, how about the journalists? 99 journalists killed. The worst in a conflict in this period of time since they started recording these numbers in 1992. Oops, we did it again. We murdered all those journalists all by accident. We killed more than Putin. We killed more journalists than Putin, okay? And let alone all the other dictators in the world. But it was, you're asking us to believe that was all an accident. That's insanity. Let alone the 6-year-old girl. Again, Israel told the coordinates of a 6-year-old girl inside of a car. Her family's been killed already. They're saying, do not kill her, we're sending an ambulance. Israel says, go ahead, send the ambulance. You know what they do? They track the ambulance, murder the 6-year-old girl and everyone inside the ambulance. You're telling me that was a mistake? But then we saw people surrendering, white flags, no shirts, including Israeli hostages. And yesterday we shared with you Haaretz inside Israel, great reporting, pointing out, yeah, there are kill zones. And the IDF will murder anyone inside a kill zone, even if they are unarmed and civilians.
Right.
And that's why they kill their own unarmed civilians, because they're like, oh, they're inside a kill zone, murder everyone here. Oh, oops, they turned out to be Israelis. We care about their lives implicitly. you don't care about the Palestinians you've been murdering. And by the way, why is this such a giant news event? Because they killed seven people who were largely foreigners.
From, yeah, various
because
countries.
Because the Palestinian lives don't matter to Israelis or Americans or to these Western governments. They don't matter at all. Butcher them, butcher them. 32,000. You think Israel accidentally killed 23,000 women and children? Come on, who's that stupid enough to believe that? No, I'm sorry. I know it's not mainly not stupidity at all. It's mainly deep, unwavering bias. Israel is the good guy, no matter how many people they murder. No, sorry, they're not. Right now, it's not permanent, guys, and it has nothing to do with religious background. But right now, Israel is clearly one of the worst governments in the world. They have massacred more people than almost any government. Now they're murdering civilian workers. Finally, let's get to why they did this. Why did they? I mean, this is going to draw international condemnation. There's an Australian, a Polish worker, an American, a British. All the governments are going to have to pretend to be upset with Israel, and they send them billions of dollars and more bombs and jets. Oh, we are so mad you killed our citizens. Where's my money? Give me the APAC money. Give me the donor money. Okay, send them more weapons. Kill more. Who cares if they're Americans? Kill more, says Joe Biden. Be honest, Joe Biden's a monster. Okay, so why they do it? Because now that organization, along with several other aid organizations, had withdrawn from Gaza. So now the Palestinians will starve quicker. Mission accomplished. That's the terrorist that Benjamin Netanyahu is. Number one terrorist in the world right now.
Thanks for watching the Young Turks. Really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.